Now students, as you can see, I have written here rhyming scheme. In the last poem, The Kite also, I have told you, described you about the rhyming word as well as the rhyming scheme. Now, whenever we are talking about rhyming scheme of a poem or rhyming scheme of a stanza or a paragraph, we first must see whether rhyming words are present in the poem at the last of the lines or not. That means if a paragraph or stanza or a poem consists of rhyming words, that means each line has some rhyming words at its end, then only we can say that there must be some rhyming scheme. I am telling this list because there are many types of other poems, or we can say there are different types of poems written in different ways in which rhyming schemes are not present. That means there is no rhyming word at the ending. And in those poems we can't identify any rhyming scheme because they don't follow any rhyming scheme. Now as I told you that if we have to find out the rhyming scheme of the paragraph or stanza or the poem, first of all we should identify, we should find out the rhyming word. Then only we can decide its scheme. So let us first take out the rhyming word from the four lines that we have written. From the first paragraph, those paragraphs, only the four lines I have taken here to describe the rhyming scheme. Now, when we read this poem, I quarrel with my brother, I don't know what about. One thing led to another, and somehow we fell out. Now we are trying to find the rhyming word. Now as you can see, this brother is rhyming with another. Brother, another, rhyming. Again, about, fell out. This OUT portion is same in both, as this THER portion is same in, or we can say OTHER portion is same in both the parts. So we have identified the rhyming words here. Now since there are rhyming words present in this stanza, so we can say that a rhyming scheme is being followed. Now how to find out the rhyming scheme? I have also told you about this and described you about this in the last poem, The Kite. So let us once again learn it so that from the next time you will be able to find out the rhyming scheme on your own. Now as I told you, depending upon the sound, we denote an alphabet to the word. For example, our first word is brother. So we are starting with A. Usually we start with A as the first alphabet of the English, or we can say first letter of the English alphabet. So I have given A to the sound of brother. Now since brother is rhyming with another, so this will also be denoted as A. Brother, another, same sound, same rhyming pattern, so we have denoted it with A. Now coming to the second sound, that is above, it is different from the sound of brother, so we have denoted it with B. And since it is being rhyming with the out, it is rhyming with out, that is why we will tell it as B. Now you can see that the scheme is coming, that is A, B, A, B. That means the rhyming scheme of this is a line that I have taken from the first stanza of the poem. So students, we can get 4 lines, we can get 8 lines, and as well as we can get a whole poem to find out the rhyming scheme. So we will first, as I told you the step, we will first identify the rhyming word, and depending upon the sound of those rhyming words, we will denote it with some alphabet, and then according to those sounds and the alphabet we have denoted it, we will find out the rhyming scheme. So now students, I am going to give you the whole paragraph of the first stanza of the poem The Quarrel to find out the rhyming scheme. Now students, you can see I have added the next 4 lines also of the first stanza of the poem. Now, as I told you, the rhyming scheme can be of the whole part of the stanza or the whole stanza. Now, if we are asked to take out the rhyming scheme of the whole stanza, then how we will do? As I told you earlier, first of all, we will identify the rhyming word. Till the 4th line we have already identified it. Now from the 5th line we are going to identify. Now here we can see that slide and rhyme, I-G-H-T, are having rhyming sounds, as well as wrong, strong and wrong. These two are also having rhyming sound. Now, as we have already denoted A and B to the sound of these rhyming words, and slide is different sound from the above, so we will denote it with C. Okay, since this slide sound is totally different from brother, about, another, out, it is totally different from that sound, so we are denoting it with C. And since this sound is rhyming with this sound, so this will also be the C. Now, two words are remaining, that is strong and wrong. Now, you can see that strong is again a new sound that is not there in all the above. So, we will denote it with B. And since it is rhyming with this one, this will also be the D. Now, students, you can see the alphabet ends are A, B, A, B, C, D, E, D. Now, as I told you that the rhyming scheme of this whole stanza will be now A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D. The rhyming scheme of this whole stanza. Clear? I hope now it is being clear. The portion that you are being given, you have to identify that portion only. Now, one more thing, as I told you in the starting, that sometimes the same theme is followed in the other paragraphs of the same poem also. And in that cases, we will say that the rhyming scheme of this poem, not only the paragraph, not only the stanza, not only the line, but then we will say the rhyming scheme of the poem is such and such, because in all the paragraph, in all the stanza, the same rhyming scheme will be repeated. So students, I hope now the rhyming scheme is clear to you all, as we have just discussed it in the last poem, The Kite, as well as in the poem, The Quarrel. So students, I hope you have understood the whole poem properly. You have learned the recitation properly, and you have also followed the way to identify the rhyming scheme. So I hope you must have understood it well.